10 easy ways to restore and protect your skin, get your elasticity back, because the drooping, the falling, the fine lines, the wrinkles, they're all from collagen and elastin. That's the primary problem, and that's why people come to clinics to get treatments done. There's nothing better than giving my patients that perfect report card. No treatments necessary, a little bit of skincare. We'll see you in a year. I'm sharing my top 10 tips so you can get that same report card for you. So let's start by first looking at the graph of collagen loss over time. Look at the huge drop on this graph around menopause. We know that, but also look at it starting at the age of 30. And that's more and more common. Unfortunately, we're seeing this from a younger and younger age. It's why this video is so important for everyone. The more you keep and maintain of this collagen, the better it will be. Now, some of you missed the boat years ago. I'm 50, I'm 60, did I miss the boat? This video is important for you too, because now you can even restore some collagen. So we'll help you as well with these tips. So the word we're looking for here is elasticity. Elasticity is that physical stretch, the bounciness of the skin to pop back. So you're going to notice that lack of bounce first where? Around the eyes. That's a driver to practices. Slowly, you'll see that crinkled texture and the luster degrade around the mouth, lip lines, vertical lip lines, smoker's lines, barcode lips. Then finally, the cheeks and the jawline, because bone does play a role in those areas. Okay, number one, hyaluronic acid. One of the best skin products on the market for elasticity is non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid with large and small molecules within it. This gets right into your pores and encourages growth and plumpness of soft tissue while keeping the skin hydrated, attracting water, and boosting the levels of your collagen and elastin proteins. These are all proteins. You'll notice right away from the firm, elastic feel that this product gives you, and it can easily erase even some deeper wrinkles if you give it some time. Now, you have to stay hydrated for this to work, so put it on your face while it's still moist, and remember to hydrate from within. It should be also your first layer before your moisturizer that might then lock in the hyaluronic acid. Some people do put an active like a retinol on top. It will make that retinol work better or be stronger, so be mindful for that. Number two, vitamin C. To further our first tip, vitamin C actually stimulates hyaluronic acid and collagen synthesis. So you get a double hit there. Get vitamin C heavy in your diet through supplements and by consuming a lot of citrus fruits, green vegetables, broccoli, cabbage, and Brussels sprouts. Even though you guys don't like them, they're a high source of vitamin C. You'll see this vitamin bring your skin back to life. Topically, I prefer best. And by applying it, you're getting that synergistic effect. You want to look for about 15% in your skincare. That's the concentration level, 15 to 20%, but not everyone seems to tolerate the 20, but if you can, all the better. Apply it as a second step after the hyaluronic acid and use it in the morning so it thwarts the effect of sun. I sometimes, if I'm getting a lot of sun, I put it on in the evening as well. It's one of the most studied skincare products on earth. And in going with study, number three, sunscreen. SPF should always be the last step of your morning skincare routine. There's no need to use it at night for most people. You're not getting sun. But in the morning, your last step. Nothing's going to absorb through your sunscreen to work. So your active products are first, sunscreen last. It's absolutely essential because it protects the skin from harmful UV rays, and these are proven to destroy collagen. They're proven to do it. So using the SPF regularly will let your proteins live and restore that elasticity in your skin. It helps the machinery of your hyaluronic acid and your collagen pop up a couple steps because the sun beats it down. And we want to make more than we chew up, because you naturally chew up hyaluronic acid and collagen elastin. And we make less and less as we get older because of that sun damage. So protection's key. Now, a lot of people worry about white casting. That comes from your mineral sunscreen. But a lot of people don't want chemical sunscreen because they're worried about the chemicals. I have videos on those. But if you're worried and you want a mineral, you don't want the white cast. So when you put it on, it leaves a white sheen to your skin. People won't wear it. That's called the white cast. I tell people use that mineral tinted sunscreen, and most people love it. We have one in our site. It's from Revision. It works really well. People are happy, and it blends with most skin colors. So look for something like that. What I don't want people to do is avoid sunscreen because they don't like that discoloration. It's key. Number four, fish oils. Omega-3 fatty acids from fish are used and secured right in your skin layers, locking in that hydration and supporting elasticity. On my site, you'll see a formulation for krill oil. I much prefer krill to fish oil, and I have many videos on why, but it's more bioavailable for one. It's sustainable. It is not rancid. A lot of fish oil people use ends up getting rancid, and it has astaxanthin. That's the key. Fish oils typically don't have astaxanthin, and astaxanthin is one of the most powerful antioxidants on earth. It's found in krill oil, but whichever one you use, fish or krill, it helps collagen production. Number five, exfoliation. Don't over exfoliate. But there is a need to remove dead skin cells, and regular exfoliating will increase the strength and thickness of that epidermal layer. As you manually cycle out of your old skin cells and you bring in the new, you'll see softer, brighter texture with stronger lift, more collagen. And your actives, your skincare, will work better. It doesn't have to go through all those dead skin cells. There's chemical and physical exfoliation. I have complete videos on those. Number six is going to be witch hazel. It's rich in powerful antioxidants that rid free radicals and help protect your elastin and collagen that you already have and help build more. Some skin types are a bit sensitive to witch hazel, but using it as a toner in skincare seems to work well for people, and they tolerate it. But something you want to consider. Number seven, collagen supplementation. Now, collagen is one of the two main proteins in skincare that supports elasticity. Current research boasts collagen supplements to reduce wrinkles, smooth out texture, take years off your skin. And if you look at the comments under my videos on collagen powder, you'll see people support it. They say, yeah, I first see my hair, skin, and nails get better, and then I see my joints improve, kind of in that order. Look for ones with fish, cow or bovine, and chicken source. So I like all three, multiple hydrolyzed collagen. Now, if you don't want to spend money on a collagen powder, I take collagen powders, even no matter if I'm taking other sources of collagen or not, because I know I'm getting a base level. But if you want to and you have time, you can make your own with bone broth at home. If you're using collagen powder, one key is look for unflavored. It has less sugar. Watch my videos on collagen powder. Number eight, ginseng tea. Now, many of you are already drinking this, but it's one of the most clinically proven teas in skincare. We love ginseng. It has diverse properties of antioxidants and natural B vitamins. B vitamins are the key here, and a lot of times you don't get them from other sources. These elements of vitamins bring collagen and elastin to the epidermis while increasing healthy blood flow and circulation. Number nine, face massage. Now, when we're testing skincare, we use what we call a placebo, which is something that might have a little carrier in it, but nothing active. And then we have our active product that we're trying to test. Well, the placebo group gets better. They might get 20, 30, 40% improved over the active group, which may get 60 or 70% improved, but still something with nothing in it, they get better. Why? Because they're massaging, they're putting something on their skin. We know massage has some benefits by increasing blood flow, it might exfoliate a little bit, and just by paying attention to the skin. So getting in a moisturizing face massage in your nighttime skincare routine can stimulate and contour your face muscles. Always massage upwards and against the gravity that pulls down. Starting from your neck, of course, and then your jawline, and working your way up is the best way to do it and enhance skin quality. Now, number 10 is sleep. Of course, It seems like we can never get enough, right? I talk a lot in my practice about sleep for skincare because my patients who get high quality sleep look younger. And I will always touch on this with them because it really can't be compromised. Inconsistent sleep can cause your body to produce that stress hormone, cortisol. And as we know, stress puts the unnecessary years right on your face. So prioritize time management, get your sleep in order. If you get those 10 factors going for you, I can tell you, you're going to look 10 years younger. If you like this video, I put a complete video up here on supplements and nutritional things you can do at home, and one down here on skincare routines you can do at home. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.